A very warm welcome to all of you. Good morning. This is Shirish Yadav here. I am representing Capricor Technologies here as the marketing head. We are going to have a very wonderful session today on Maya. Okay, it will be headed by our technical manager, Mr. Jignesh Mistry. He will be taking you through a walkthrough on the new features and the amazing shortcuts and various techniques that you need to use while using Maya 2024.
Various of our clients over the world, they have used Maya for their project, and you could also see that there was a bit of a making of Doctor Strange Multiverse Madness. Those are some of the few that projects that people have used Maya for their projects. Otherwise, the sky is the limit for when it comes to that. Now, being a part of Media and Entertainment Collection, Maya comes. Maya and 3ds Max are the hero product with Arnold packaged with it, and Motion Builder and Mudbox. Media and Entertainment Collection, you do get 5 nodes of Arnold 2, which would be helpful for your network rendering. Also, they have some of the services like Recap and Autodesk rendering part also. So, coming to that, I'm gonna showcase some of the features of Maya 2024, which they have actually introduced. Again, as I told, that Retopology is one of the tools that they had introduced in past. They did that in 2020, 19 and 2020 was something where they actually released Retopology. Over the time, they tried to reduce the timing of Retopology on the heavy meshes. And now what they have actually come up across is like they will be preserving your edges also. The idea over here is like if you are actually making if you are actually doing a retopology of your heavy scanned mesh, which people do a lot in Hollywood actually. You will be also seeing such kind of a trend in Bollywood also, because the challenge of making things more realistic is also being faced by Bollywood these days. Now, maybe the trend that they would be we will be able to see in future is like how it's going to be. I'm just giving a very fair example here that a sculptor, a proper sculptor, could be sculpting his art in clay. That art has been scanned in 3D and then brought it into Maya. This is one way of working in the hero product. I mean, like the hero character that you have, and you want that exact look. So many times what people think is, I can sculpt it, but I cannot do it in digital sculpting. You have some limitations. So a proper artist who has a very good hand on clay, he will be actually making the entire model in clay, and then the entire model is being 3D scanned and brought it into Maya. Now, when it is being brought in Maya, it has such kind of a heavy mesh altogether. So what I'm trying to tell you over here is, suppose if I open up in Maya, and in Maya, the very first thing that I can actually come across is something like this. Say, suppose, of course, this thing is not that heavy as such, but then I intend to just take it as a retopology for this map, this so-called beast. So if I want to do a retopology on this one, what they have actually brought up over here is like you can scan the mesh for issues. These settings, what they have done is they have kept like an AI coding in these settings. Majorly all of these settings that they are adding up now these days is based on AI. The smart settings are there. So you'll be seeing such kind of a more smart settings available now in Maya, which will be actually reducing your flaws of your meshes and try to give you more perfect and better model that you can come across. So suppose if you have such kind of a model, and if I clicked on something like this, just a sec. Sorry, I'm getting an error. Okay, the attribute has been set to in loss. Okay. Setting. Okay. And making it ignore and continue. Okay, fine, no problem. I'll just go along with this file altogether. What you can see over here is like this is the mesh that you are getting it right now. And after you do a bit of a retropo in this one, click over here, retropo, continue. It gives you like this. So this is an example that I was trying to tell you. That say, suppose if you have any sort of a mesh or anything like that, they try to intend to preserve your edges, okay? And at the same time, the shape of your model. So it will be making it more animatable, or you can say more texturable model. Because what happens over here is, suppose if I have to tear off the UVs of these model, it is a bit of a challenge to do something like that, right? So say suppose if I just follow the instruction, a bit of selection is to be revealed and insufficient into this thing, using a manual of a quadro, automatically you can actually retropo this one. I don't know if how many people have been using this feature, but I'll just show you a bit of a thing. So suppose if you can use quadro, right? I don't know if you use this. Can you see this? Mention me in the comment section if anybody has been using this quad draw. What it does is like it would be actually making quads out of your mesh over here. I'll make a simple new one and I'll show you on this. So suppose if you have like this. Sorry. I have to do a live set, so I think I'll make a new one, open up this one itself. Don't save. Beginning, seven. Go into the retropology. It will be giving you a retropo here. Oh, yes. Then you have like this and this. Seeing it here. There is a hard meshes over here. What I'll be doing in my meshes, coming into mesh display. Mesh display, 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 display. This way. Yeah. And here, make it soft edges. And pressing over control edges, continuous edges. Okay, now once this is done, I'll be clicking on my mesh and making it hard. That is the hard edges. Okay, and now if I give this one a retropology and click on hard edges, what it did over here is it preserved my edges. Can you see this? Right? So what by doing this exercise, what I try to do over here is say if you have edges which need to be preserved properly in an organic model like a beast or any creature, it may not be that relevant. But say suppose if you have a hard car or something like a bolt like this one, and that need to be retropo, fine, it will be giving a root topology. It did give me a very good mesh and all together, but many of my shape and edges were disrupted while in doing that kind of a process. So after doing a bit of a hard edges and preserving that edges, I'm able to get the exact shape. Okay, so this is the new enhanced improvement that they have done in 2024. People might be saying, is this relevant or not? I mean, see, those people who are facing such kind of issues while they are working, they will be finding it more relevant. And I'll be encouraging all those modelers out there, try to model or try to do work on those models that you have got as a scan model, something like that. Okay. And then apply this technique over here. What I did is like simply made the original mesh, okay, then preserved the hard edges by making the display over here by giving in a hidden hard edges and retropolarizing that. And in retropology, I do get something like hard edges over here, right? So that's what they have done it. And you can also change the angle if you want. I mean, like make it 90 or whatever. It's up to you, right? I'm just giving in just an example here, okay? And make it more nice and shiny. Can you this? Right? Okay. So this is the idea of preserving the hard edges. And the same thing has been running into over here in this case of a screwdriver. If you want, I'll do it again. Try running it a retropology here. Okay. And as you can see, the entire mesh has been disrupted. Okay. So say suppose if I this result is not something that I want. Then I'll be pressing it again. Try the hard edges. Oh, sorry. Edge by angle. Oh, sorry. I'm sorry. The Maya has stuck. Just a sec. I'm sorry. Something is stuck right now while working. This is fine, right? Oh, this file is not working. I'm sorry. I'll just try to reopen it. Sorry, something went happened over here. This Maya got stuck. But my point is, like, as I just mentioned it, the edges can be preserved now, and you can get much more sharper and harder look that you can actually find out. Okay. Moving on, we also get something like a Pro Boolean. Many of the people who were been working in Maya in past must be actually looking into this. Just a sec. For some reason, Maya has been stuck. Just a sec. I'll try to remove this. Yes. End task. If it did, no. Thank you. Much better. Maya. Yes. There is a reason why I have kept this one Maya open. I wanted to show you the Bifrost feature at the end. So, stay tuned for that. Sorry for this. I'll move on to the Pro Boolean part. Yeah. So when it comes to Pro Boolean, what they have done now in Maya is like introduced a very good Boolean interface that they have done it. I'll make it something from scratch, like a cylinder. Okay. And give this one a bit of a subdivision so that it can support my thing. And select the polygon. I'll give this one a torus, no problem. Okay. Shift D, yeah, D, right? So, suppose if I require holes of this torus in between my cylinder, just click over here, come into your Boolean. That would be in my modeling, mesh, and Boolean. I'll make it union over here. Okay, and select all the torus, just a Pro Boolean, all the meshes, again, my Pro Boolean. Mentioning it over here, the cylinder is my union and torus would be my A, E, B, B, and A, B. Okay, right? And this last, The idea over here is like this is fairly very interactive now. That means, so suppose if I want to increase or decrease the size or move them, I can do that. So if I want this one to be less, this one to be more, I can do that, right? So earlier, the Boolean that we had in past Maya versions, they were good enough. They were creating less of a havoc, but such kind of an interactivity was something which was missing in past. But now they have actually introduced it more further. You can actually work around the interaction like you want it like an edges or normal, whatever way you want to. You want it in a shaded way. I mean, this is just for the look and like part, nothing else. But the point is I can get it in as interactive as I want it. Plus, this is animatable. I've used it for animation, and trust me, it really gives me a very good output. So suppose if I made it S, and by 20, I'll make it animation like this. Then, of course, if it is for the animation, why don't I do it for all? S and S. So by the time it comes to 20, it's like this. This one is like this. This one is like this. Just playing along. And trust me, you will see amazing results. Whatever you want, check it out. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't switch on my auto key. My bad. Yes. Okay. Right. And this one. Like this. Okay. So a bit of a zigzag. I made it like a very zigzag sort of a way. This is what you can get. Right. So it is animatable. It is however way you want to. And as you can see, my cache is also getting made. So cache is something which I intend to, as an animator, cache would be playing a very vital role while you are working in animation, because it will be actually capturing your entire timeline and very easy to play within that. I've already mentioned it in my PPT in further. If you can see this, this is something that I just shown you right now. And further, moving on, is like our graph editor has been way, way improved what we used to have earlier. We have now a curve sculpting tool, which has grab, smooth, and smear now. And it will be making your animation much more precise and whichever way you want to. Because earlier days, I do remember I had to, whenever we are doing sort of an animation, I have to actually adjust each and every key. Okay. Now I can just grab a bunch of keys and make it as adjustable as possible. This is something that you will be enjoying it a lot. I'll make it give you a practical example also for that. This one, and don't say. So I have this character over here, and which has already been animated. And what it does is like something like this. You can see. Play along. It's like this. Now, if you can notice, there is a bit of a jerk while he's jumping. And I'm not so much comfortable while working on that jerk. I mean, like, I want it to be improved. Okay. So, suppose if you see on the new graph editor now, I hope everybody can see. Okay. In new graph editor, you get something like new tools, which is Graph tool, okay, Smooth tool, and Smear tool. Okay, this is something that is very newly introduced in 2024. Now, if you can see this, how I will be actually attempting it to make it more less jerky, as when it is actually jumping, it's giving me a bit of a jerk. I don't want this jerk to happen. So what I'll do is like, simply come into my, click me, this one. And it gives me a bit of curves here. Can you see this? These are the curves. So I'll just click on the translate and check it out. There is a ghost already been prepared for this character over here. And what I want over here is like this ghost, I have to just match it accordingly. And by smear, just making it like this. Can you see this? And if you play, it gives me like this. This is something like a client's correction that that has been given to me. Client asked me, this is a bit low of a jump. I wanted more higher. So earlier, what we used to do is like, we have to just grab these keys and then move on and do it further. But now, not anymore. You can just click on your grab tool over here and you can grab and do it. You can even further smooth it. Can you see this? So as an animator, this tool would be very, very useful for you, because by simple adjustment like these makes your animation more precise and more alive for that matter. I'll just spend some more time in this section altogether. If you can just see this in the 24, can you see this? I want this to move further. Right, and if I just play it along, do it like this, and if I clicked on Z, I just want them to be selected. This is the tricky part. Just a sec. 28, right? This is, 28, okay. And if you can just click on the smear tool, you can increase or decrease this tool set. Can you see this? And at the same time, double click on this. You can get like a size adjustment of that particular thing. I want to like decrease the size by 12, and I have to just adjust it to this two different part. Now, I agree that you do get like a live curve over here in this particular tutorial, saying that you have to just match it. But imagine doing this on one single key. And now all you can do is like just simply click and drag it. That's it, nothing else. Okay, and if you just play this, move further. So this is one example that I was actually wanted to share with you, that how a day-to-day animator would be actually facing such kind of a thing in his life. I mean, adjusting to this part. You can just see, shift select the example, and on the Y part of both, send this, this and this, right? I can reduce the size also by pressing B, so that I can work on each and every key as per what I'll be adjusting it. Okay. On the other part, click, trick, trick, trick. Right? So many of the animators in the panel, you will be able to relate to me. This is something like a day-to-day job of our animation. And now through the new graph editor, you can make these things very easy. Test it and play along with it. Of course, I being a past modeler, I was also into modeling a lot and sculpting and all those things. So for me, this is much more familiar because we used to do this all the time. We used to do this all the time. And now it is like making it much more easier. Okay. And I'll be out. There is a lot of things available right now these days in the newer version for animators, especially if those animators who will be actually working on their pre-production while they are working in Maya. I mean, what happens here is like for pre-production, we always depended upon paper and pencil. Fine, that's the traditional way of doing it, to be very frank. And this is my final animation. I'll just make it like this. So my, as you can see, this particular robot is like now able to jump without any jerk and much more higher. Right? Okay. So you can also do a bit of a play blast of this one wherever you want to. And now the play blast is GPU based also. So that's why it would be much more faster, accurate, and you can adjust the time frame as per you want it. I'm like, there's no stopping over here. Okay. So anyways, so this is, and it gives me a congratulation that you have done it properly, a proper job. I'll share you these tutorial if you want to work on these tutorial. All you have to do is like register yourself on area.com and you will be able to find all these tutorials and key features over here. If you can see this, also, I was actually looking into other stuffs also. But on area, you'll be able to see all these tutorials as per your and the articles that you needed. So, I encourage you guys to please go ahead and join Area for free, and you'll find a lot and lot of updates that are there by created by people all over the world, and you can apply it into your projects, right? So moving on further, this was something that I was asking for the animation, the curve part, but also there is something known as the new features, which I really loved this part, is pencil tool. What I'm trying to tell you over here is suppose if you want to do a pencil and draw certain things to be pinpointing on my animation, I can do that. And at the same time, this is animatable. So it's something like this. Right, so you can use this thing for your advantage for creating certain specific curves or something like that. I'll give you an example on the tutorial way if you want. Like over here, blue pencil demo. Have a look. Okay. Starting it over here, you can just draw as I was drawing it, something like this. And you can actually also change the color of your pencil in the icons over here. And yeah, This is the one. This is the panel that you can actually go for. And if you want a different color, like, I don't know, orange. And done. Coming into my pencil. Right? So you can also change colors like this. Colorization can create and indicate. Move it if you want. You can also move them. So you have to be in that particular time frame, and then say, suppose if I want to move it, or say, suppose if you want to copy it or paste it, you want to copy this and paste it again here, right? This is again pasted here. You can cut it and do whatever you want to. I mean, like, you can do copy pasting of your things and everything, right? And this is a small example that you can actually go for. Have a look. This is a small suggestion that was being given to me with one of my clients. He wanted this to be filled with, I mean, his head should be properly used as a football rather than he's doing a football. So if you want to do something like that, you can actually place it like this. Check it out. I can do text animation, or I mean, just writing up on the text. You can also have use text over here, whatever way you want to. Right? So mention it, yeah, do this, do that within your screen. This is not renderable. Let me be very clear on that, right? This, whatever work that you are doing on Maya, the sketching part, the correction part, this blue pencil is totally not renderable, okay? Only thing is, like, it would be able to use as a classic way of correction or classic way of using your animation in such a way. This is the one. Okay, and moving on. So what my client is asking is, rather than a football, he should use his head as a football. And chop. Right? So this is a new feature which has been introduced to 2024, the blue pencil animators. You can go ahead and use it into your projects. Okay, now moving on. Further, there are the options that are being available. Oh, sorry. This is the one. Yes. Maya. Further, what I'll be actually using here is, these are the things that I covered for my webinar, where I can smooth it, I can grab it, I can smear it in my graph editor. Okay. USD is a universal scene description. In Maya, you got USD by 2020, from 2020 version. Over the years, people have been using it and seeing a lot of difference in that particular section. A lot of improvement has been done in this particular segment. And I'll be actually showing you what all things would be what all things has been improved in 2024. Now, before moving on further, if anybody in the panel has any question or regarding any specific feature, please do ask me. Anybody is there? I can see. Yeah, of course, I'll share the link of this particular site, the area. It's even you can Google it on right away. Just go, type in area, autodeskarea.com, and you can get all these sites all easily available over there, free of cost. No charges at all. Okay, I got one question from Hardik Samir. Anybody else has any questions or whatever work that we have covered so far? Yeah.
Yeah, hi Jignesh, Rushabh here.
Yeah.
I just wanted to understand that the tools, the ghost thing which you showed in the animation part, So will that appear automatically, or is it is something which you just created for the demo?
This is something that I made it for the demo.
Okay.
But that is made by that pencil that I just showed.
Okay.
That what I'm trying to tell you here is, like, say, suppose if you are using this pencil tool. This tool.
No, sorry. Not for this one. The animation graph editor, the thing you were showing.
Huh?
In that you got a dummy curve as well. Where
That was just for the demo.
Okay.
That was just for the demo part. I mean, as I just told you in my this thing, that that ghost was something was been given to me saying that I want this character to be like that.
Okay.
I mean, like it should have the movement like that. So it was just for the demo. Nothing else.
Okay. Thank you.
Any other questions? Yeah. I'm actually going on. I'll be deep diving more on USD. I just halted for a while just to take your questions. I'll be further deep diving in USD. Okay. Any other? Shall I move on further in USD? All right. Okay. So. Moving on further on USD concept. So USD was something which they actually released in 2020. What it does is, like, traditionally speaking, if people wanted any file to be transferred from one software to another, or even within Autodesk, say suppose if I've made something in Max and I want to transfer it into Maya, the best extension that I can use was FBX within Autodesk, and say suppose if I want to use it in from another software, then an OBJ was something that we used it traditionally. Later on, there was a bit of a need that what if I want to have my materials also? What if I want to have my lighting information, the shading information, or say suppose if I want to interlink between my shading information and with my current Maya file, and so on and so forth, will I able to do such kind of a flexible work? So again, this USD was actually properly developed by Pixar. They sold it to Autodesk, and now it is easily available in all of the version post 2020. What they have been doing up till now here is, suppose if I use a USD directly, I'll just make it a new scene and I'll show it from scratch. Up till now, what we were able to do is it's just a simple import and export of USD. So say suppose if I clicked over here, and in my USD, if I used scene like where is my layout, yeah, initial layout, import it, and this is the layout that I can get it. So you can see all the information and everything has been available over here. But further, so suppose if I want to use my shading networks or anything like that, I'm able to click on all of my meshes individually, which is all fair and good, no problem at all. Okay, but say suppose if I want to use shades, or say suppose shading information about certain things which I want to change. In the older version of Maya, we were not able to do something like that. Okay, now what they have done is, say suppose if I want to use this as even for my shading network and everything, all I have to do here is simply use this window. USD layer editor. This is a new version and new thing that has been introduced. USD layer. Okay. All you have to do is, like, I have already a USD file. I'm making very simple right now. I'm not doing a very complex scene over here. I have just a USD file which I have already adjusted and exported as USD. I'll be just importing that file within my scene. That's all I'll be doing it. Okay. For that, say suppose if I'll make it more interesting. what I'll do here is I have an animation. Okay, just a scenario. This one. Okay, this is an animation. Where is it? Sorry. Did I got it? No. Oh. Okay. Really? I do have this, but I wanted the animation here. I'm so sorry. My animation is missing here. Mm-mm. How could that be? Ah, of course, I can use that. Sorry, I just wanted my animation to appear. There was a character that was animated. For some reason, it was not appearing it. Maya. What happened? Right. So new scene. Da-da-da-da. Open. Where is it living? Okay, so I think I have used a wrong file. Yes. Don't say. Yes. This is the animation that I had. Okay. Made it for this. Six. Okay. As you can see, the cache has been made. Of course. Play every frame, 24 frames per second. Save it. Yes. So this is an animation that I've made for where it has been looking into the scene, and then it will be sitting it over there. This is an animation, okay? Of course, my BG is missing. My entire BG and everything is missing. I will be calling it. So old way was like just simply click over here and import, and it would be called upon. But now, so suppose if you can use a USD layer, creating it from the stage file, okay? Living room. Okay. Create. I think it's just a sec. I'll reopen it. Don't say. Okay. Come in. USD layer. Create from a layout, create. Yes, this is a proper one. Okay, sorry, I accidentally used a different one. Now, as you can see, the layout is there, okay, but I mean, my character is going within that particular chair. I don't want that, no problem. Just simply select these and move it further. Okay, and in the addition, this particular cage is also bothering me. I can move it further. Just the cage, nothing else. And make this 0. Okay, so these all freedom you can get it while using USD. And furthermore, I'll just share you something more. And it sits over there. Yeah, this is the thing. So this is quite well established. Now, so suppose if I want to deep dive further and change certain aspect of my mesh or certain aspect of my scene, Can I do that? Yes. So suppose, especially when it comes to shading. So I have checked on, clicked on chair over here. Click over here. See, this is, these are the chair elements that I'm having it. And in further, you get this cut mesh and cut mat SG. Now, these are your shaders. Control A. Okay. Can you see this? If I want to change certain things in this shader, there is a new thing introduced in Maya 2024, which is LookDave X, right? It's a graph editor. It's a new graph editor. All you have to do is like show in LookDave X, right? And double click over here and you get all your shading information right away. This is blue. I don't want it blue. Fine. I want it red. And I can change it. So scene management is much more efficient now and much, much more, you can say, user-friendly than what it used to be. Because in newer in older version, I was not able to get these things. These entire graph information about my shading. Also, so suppose if I want to change a certain aspect of the shader, I can also do that without any problem. And it is renderable, it is render ready, and you can make sure that your scene is much more less, I mean, in our technical term, less heavy. Okay, it would be much more less heavier than what it used to be. You can call reference within the, your existing scenes by just simply adding up over here, like XForm. Okay. And in XForm, if say, suppose if I want to call it as assign a new material, if you want to, that's up to you. Or else, if say, suppose if I want to add a new USD, whatever way you want to. I'm not doing it right now. I'm just showing you what all things that you can actually do within USD and the USD layer these days. So keeping in mind the demand that you actually place forth in forums, in area.com, and Autodesk do listen to you. Frankly speaking, they do listen to you. They see all the comments, whatever comment has been mentioned on area forums about a certain tool, certain aspect, and they try to introduce a better update over the year that they actually release a newer version. The new version is released only and only when it is stable and production ready. That's all I can say. They are not releasing it in any sort of hassle that if it is buggy, then they will make sure that the bugs are been removed. So my only request to all of the panelists and all the attendees today is like, please register yourself on area.com. Be active on area. People will listen to you and they will make changes in Maya as per your needs. Okay. Any questions in USD? If anybody has any questions. USD, okay, I have a question from an anonymous attendee. I don't know the name over here. USD is actually an extension of a scene or a file, you can say that way. As I mentioned in my earlier, what we used to do is like we used to call references of a different model. Whatever that model is, it's in OBJ, it's in FBX, in any other format that you have. Okay, you call it in one scene. Okay, and then that entire scene, if you want to call it as a reference, the only thing that we had in Maya was call it as reference, and the Maya file would be call it as a reference into it. I mean, the reference editor, through your reference editor. That is a typical production pipeline, okay? What USD has been doing is it will be giving you more further details about your material, and your lighting information and everything. Okay, so no need of baking your light and anything. Just simply create your lights and everything, set your scene and export it as USD and call it in USD layer, as I showed you. And you can adjust your lighting and everything as it is. I mean, no hassle. And at the same time, your file size would be much more light. That's what it's trying to do. So that's what USD is. And it was being discovered on floor. If I be more specific, Moana was one of the project that they actually used, where they used USD very extensively. Zootopia was another one. If you can see how many meshes and how many characters were been used in Zootopia. I mean, they were like, you can see the animals and animals and the endless tree. How on earth they would be able to handle the entire scene as it is. So USD made that particular process very easy. And at the same time, they made sure that that particular character, the hero character, stays in a different way, and the rest of the crowd is adjusted differently. So my point is, like, when you are working in production, you will be having a need of using such kind of an extension. So USD fills that gap. That's what it does. Okay. Any other questions? I'll just see if there is any other question. There is. In Max, we can apply Arnold material, but now we import scene in Maya. But now we want to render it in V-Ray also. That is, say, suppose if we are talking about 3ds Max, Mr. Naresh, right? V-Ray, so that the time, how USD would be able, helpful to change material in the entire scene. See, when it comes to V-Ray support, I need to check if USD supports V-Ray material or not. Because again, it's a plugin sort of a thing. I just need to check whether it supports or not. If it does, then of course, you will be able to get the V-Ray material options in LookDev. So suppose if you see in this LookDev X, you will be able to see right now all the attributes which are there for Arnold. Okay. So if the V-Ray material is supported, which I'm sure it should be, I'm not checked it, but if it supports, then yes, you will be getting all the V-Ray attributes over here and you can adjust it. Okay. Any other questions? Okay. Thank you. Why follow path and not allow character walk cycle after completing two steps? I didn't quite understand. I mean, you're talking about that character that we saw, the walk cycle. Please be more specific, Mr. Mahesh, if you can. Yes, okay. So, see, follow the path as in, say, it was just for that particular demo. Okay. What I did is, like, I wanted to showcase that particular new tool, which is Smear, Smooth, and Grab. These were the three tools that I used in Graph Editor. And I was trying to match it as per the ghost that I got. Okay. That's all I did. Every animation has its own way of working it. My way was, like, I just wanted to adjust it and reduce the jerk of that particular jump. That's all I did that. Okay.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. Okay. Can USD support smoothing groups? Yes, it will. No problem at all. Make your mesh as heavy as possible or subdivide it as much as you want. It will definitely support. No problem. How I opened? Okay. I'll show you again. What I did here is I just clicked on the shaders and right click and open in LookDev X. That's how I did. Okay. I used a bit of a shortcut because it was like on that particular project. So this is how I did. This is LookDev. Okay. Yeah. Okay, I have a poll questions for you if everybody can attend on this. Shirish, are this poll questions also available for LinkedIn?
No, not LinkedIn. We have a different question. So okay. This is poll question just to see how much do how they know about these things.
No problem.
So
no
we'll have the exclusive question at the very end in the next few minutes.
Okay. Yeah. So what is the key update of Retropology in Maya 2024? I'm sorry that file got a bit crashed, so I had to move on, but I definitely covered this part. Let's see how many people can attend this. Okay, time is up. How many people? Oh, nice. 53 people told that edge preservation. So you were listening what I was saying. And sorry for that technical error. I was actually going further, but unfortunately, the file stuck for some reason. Okay.
So I think we have a raise of hand by Paras Gada.
Paras Gada. Okay. Yes.
Yeah, Paras, so you may go ahead. I have unmuted you. You can unmute and you can speak.
Hello, Mr. Paras.
Paras, if you want, you can also post the question in
Post
the
Q&A. Question, yes, yes, yeah. Please. You can also post the question. Yeah. Yes, yes. If you're not able to speak or for some reason.
Okay. Meanwhile, Jignesh, one of them is Hardik Simlani. He requested if he can share the link for the community.
Yeah. Of course, it is there. If you want, this is area. This is area.com.
Just paste that link into the chat.
Sure.
Chat box. Yeah, so that everyone can have it.
Okay.
So, guys, as a part
this is
of
the
this,
one. Yeah. And this is the tutorial that you can follow. Mr. Matt Chan, okay, he's an authorized Autodesk speaker for us, and you can follow his work wherever you want to, and other articles also. I do encourage you, please go ahead and see other articles, increase your knowledge while regularly visiting on area.com. Okay, I'll just simply copy this one and mention it on the chat for everyone. Host and panelist. I can only see host and panelist. Will everybody be able to?
Yeah. So just one. Right?
I'll just.
So you can just switch it to everyone.
I'm not able to get everyone. I'm just getting host and panelist.
Okay, just one.
Right? Yeah.
Okay, you can just post it. I'll repost it to everyone.
Okay. I'll just. Yeah. Posting it. Yeah. So, see, I have nothing to hide or anything. Everything is there online. People are very smart these days. They just go online and they can get all these things. All I can do is guide you, see these things and increase your knowledge. That's what I'll be doing for the entire thing. Of course, if you want me to take some more specific topics in detail, I'd be more than happy to arrange a webinar or something like this for everyone or a specific group of people. And we can have a brainstorming session on that particular topic also. No problem at all. Whatever I'm showing you right now is a highlights of the new feature of 2024 Maya. If you want within this highlight to have a very specific topic, do let us know. We'll definitely do a webinar on that. Okay? Sounds good, Suresh?
Yeah, sounds about good.
Yeah.
So guys, to take this session to the last phase of today's discussion.
Now I'm about to enter into the last part. That's why.
Yeah.
Okay? So moving on further, as I just shared you that Lookdev technology would be something which will be having Arnold Material and Material X. Okay, Material X is also a new shading network that you can look into. That is again, it's a very detailed one. If you want, again, I'll be taking a separate session for USD and Lookdev also, no problem at all. Because frankly speaking, due to time crunch, I'm just doing a highlight. And if you want a detailed session, I'll be more than happy to do something like that. Okay. Then now what you can do in rigging part. Rigging is not been ignored this year. They have been introducing a new part, new thing, updates on whatever work that you will be doing earlier. I'll make a new scene and show you from scratch. I personally loved it because earlier when I used to do a painting of the rigs of each and every thing, especially when it comes to my hands, my arms or muscle part and everything, if you want to do something like that, each and every vertex is taken under consideration, because even one or two vertex, if they are like not properly been weighted, it creates a very weird looking character. So what I'll make a very simple one from the scratch for exhibiting this particular feature. Again, back to my cylinder. Of course, if I have to do something like a scratch, either I'll take a ready-made model or create a model from scratch, to be very frank. Okay, so I'll make it, how much wide, like this one would be 6. Okay, and I'll be giving this one a further vertexes. Okay, now the best part nowadays is like, say, suppose if I'll be doing a rotate, see, it is getting rotated directly from that particular point. Okay, people who are from the older version, I have personally been struggling a lot when if I have to do a particular a vertex manually to rotate it from that particular pivot. Okay, stay with me. I mean, trust me, I was like having a nightmare during some of my major projects in past. If this feature was available back then, I would have saved a lot of time. Okay, so anyways, say if I made it a bit of an arm like this and added further cuts, click and click, I pressed it control over here. Click and click. So what I'll be doing over here is simply giving this one a skeleton. That is my rigging skeleton. Of course, many of the people would be knowing this. Tick, tick, and tick. Okay. Now you can also see it in different way. That is not just bone, but multi-box and joint way also. So like the draw style can differ now, whatever way you want to, like bone or some other way. As it's not shown much of a difference, but you can actually, this is something that they have brought up now. Anyways, so this is like this, and that's that, making it skin. First, I'll give this one an IK. Okay, select the bone like this, bind it. I don't know how many people were deep diving into this, but I prefer heat and geodic voxel. This would be giving me much more organic way of skinning. Quite smart, quite better, and I mean, it's very efficient. So this is some settings that I actually encourage you to look into. Apply. Okay. This is my IK. Right? This is the thing. So, say suppose if I clicked on my paint, can you see now? I can get numeric value of my paint. Okay, how I did? by clicking. See, by default, it would be like this. Of course, by default, it is like this. Simply, you have to click on visualization and the drop-down menu of geometric color. You can do whatever color that you want to and show on the numeric. You can increase the decimal point size so that you can able to see what our vertexes are having what weights. So in past, we had to go in Paint Editor, and then each and every vertexes has to be adjusted accordingly. And then I don't know, many times it's a bit confusing, but now due to this particular feature, it's live visualized into your project. I mean, you can actually see what bone has been using what vertexes and so on. Okay, I'm not going to paint it. I'm just showcasing you the new feature. That's it. Okay, I hope you understand. And due to heat map, I'm able to get a very precise looking muscles and everything. Trust me, you will really see a difference if you are using heat maps and geotech voxels, both. Okay. Okay, and last but not the least, in rigging, what they have actually done here is like multiple clusters can be applied into your rigs. I'll see if I can get that particular rig right now, because this is what it can be done. See, multiple clusters, as in what used to happen earlier here is like each and every cluster had to be parented in such a way rather than grouped. So now multiple clusters would be having multiple skinning values. And through that skinning value, you can have a much more precise looking facial rig. That's what they have improved now. Let's see if I can get that. Where is it? Yeah, multi-skin. So, let's save. Yeah, this is the one. Right, 5, 6. This is the one. Now, this is a bit of a lengthy process to do that. But what I'm trying to showcase on the final output here is that, say, suppose if you have such kind of a multi-clusters, earlier, the skinning part was a nightmare to do something like this. Trust, I've seen it. So what they have done is like they have, if you have such kind of a rig which has multiple cluster values, everything can be properly adjusted. So this is the final output. It took a bit of a time to achieve something like this. I just saved it like this. Okay. And at the same time, I can switch between the output so that these things can be done properly. Okay, I'm pressing 4, 5, and 6, 5, and 6, 5, and 6. So that I can just see what was earlier and what is now. Okay. So rigging has been much more improved. I would highly recommend you please apply it first and see it, because and if you want me to take a detailed video on or a webinar on this particular topic, I'll be happy to do that. I'll do it on a very scratch way, and you can it would be much more interactive session in that particular one. Let's see, I can schedule it for somewhere around, say, later on in June or July, and people would be able to attend such kind of a session later on. Okay, because this is a really lengthy one. This is the when it comes to rigging, and people who are doing rigging, they would be able to relate to me. Yeah, such kind of topics are very lengthy, and we really need to do a deep dive and see each and every aspect to make sure that you are getting a proper and perfect one. It took me around a day almost to achieve something like this. Because not just to, just to make it perfect, nothing else. Otherwise, you can just apply it and get all the skins, skinning value and everything right away. But to make it perfect, you know, like a proper way. And I was getting time in a day, I was getting what, 1 hour, 2 hours, something like that. 2 or 3 hours, I was able to achieve something like this. Okay, right? So last, but not the least, yeah. This is the caching part that I just mentioned, that it was about GPU deformation. In cache, you can actually, whatever play blast that you are actually getting right now, it can be have a GPU powered way so that it would be much more accurate while you are actually doing a play blast. I would highly recommend you, if you can actually use a play blast these days, and just make sure that the GPU is perfect in your system. Then you can actually achieve something like this. Okay. Time sliders have been much more efficient now. You can color code them as and when you require. They were there earlier, but now because of the new version, you can also name them and color code as per way you want to, and bookmark them. Something like this can be achieved in the time sliders. You can actually increase and decrease the size of it, scale it as per you want to. We were able to do it in earlier versions also. But now what they are trying to do over here is make it more efficient. I mean, just mention the numbers over there and you can jump right away and over there as and when required. Of course, this was the last thing that I wanted to show you in Bifrost. Many people in the panel actually must be using Bifrost. I at least seen Bifrost in past. Okay, what they have done now is like the Bifrost is much more user friendly to render also. Earlier, in order to do rendering in Arnold, we had to apply a specific node. But suppose if you have like Bifrost graph like this, like a network over here, which I had already prepared. Again, this is a very, very detailed topic. If you actually go into it, has some instructions. I have already used the ready-made examples of the Bifrost through which such kind of nodes you can actually achieve. So what I was trying to do over here is like, suppose if you have an Arnold render, and if you are rendering it over here, can you see this? With shadow and everything, you are able to get it. This is the improvement that they have done. Not very hanky-panky. I've just applied an area, sky dome light and given an HDRI light. That's it, nothing else. And rest everything is followed by it. Okay. And of course, I'm using a GPU. I'm sure I'm using a GPU or not. No, I don't think so. I'm using a GPU. I'm so sorry. My bad. Yes, I'm not using a GPU. Duh. So I'll be making a GPU, enabling it, and re-rendering it over here so that it would be quicker and faster. Right, so the simulation has been improved and rendering has been improved further. That's what I wanted to highlight on Bifrost. Nothing new that they have introduced, and Bifrost was already been released in 2021 version, 2020 and 2021. That was the version where they actually rewrote the entire Bifrost and made it node based, and they actually made it so detailed that you can achieve anything that you want to. Of course, this is the one. See, based on GPU, Now it is much more. I suppose after this you might be grabbing an ice cream, because by seeing this ice cream it looks more tempting. You can have a smoothie if you want, as it is very hot right now. So anyways, so this is the improvement that they have done, the rendering part of Bifrost. That's why I opened up a Bifrost file earlier, because I wanted to show you. It was taking time to simulate because it had a lot of particles within it. But when it comes to rendering, it is much more user friendly and efficient now, based on your GPU, of course. Okay, so this is the one. And in Arnold, what they have introduced is a newer physical based light also. That is a physical sun. That's what they have introduced. I'll just come in here and give this one a plane. Yeah. And red. This is what they have done. Of course, the physical sun that you are seeing over here is a totally solely Maya based Arnold physical sun. What you can do over here is increase the intensity as and when required. You can use for interiors or exteriors or in an angular manner format and make it increase exposure, less exposed. Of course, right now I'm just using a simple plane. If I can use something like a model from my... Where is it? Content browser. Yes. So if I can just import this. Of course, this one is a Babic. F. And I'm making it GPU based. Make it 5 at least. Yeah. Right. Okay, so this is the physical based sun that you can actually use for your exteriors. Now it is also available in this actually looks like any of your gaming engine. If you are familiar with some of the gaming engines like Unity and Unreal, you do get something like a physical sun. And now that physical sun is also available in Maya Arnold. That's what the newer thing that they have actually done. And I have not mentioned it in my PPT, unfortunately. But one thing that I have got the thing is, if you have a character ready, that is with the rig and animation, you can easily link it with your Unreal Engine also. All you have to do is now we do have send it to Unreal, the entire project to Unreal. Okay. But earlier it was only on the asset based. They didn't carry much of a rig weights and rigs and everything. But now even the rig can be properly send it to Unreal. That's what they the update in 2024 that they have done with the collaboration with Unreal Engine. Okay. Angular. Make it like this. Okay. Physical sun. And what else we can actually do? We can add up light. I don't want to add up right now. But make it interior and exterior and at latitude. And increase the temperature if you want to. So as it is, people are roaming around in sunlight. You can also roam around in your Maya. Okay. So, well, that's all I had to share it with you guys in Maya for 2024. If I have missed any topic, please do let me know. I can actually deep dive in that particular topic again, and we can meet up for 2024 and newer updates as and when it will be coming. Due to time constraint, I'll be actually ending up right now. If anybody has any questions, you can ask right now. And this is my contact number and email address. Please do follow us on LinkedIn also at Capricorn Media and Entertainment. Give us your suggestions on your upcoming webinars. As I told you, this is one series of 2024 version webinar. Capricorn as in whole will be also sending out some newer features for AutoCAD, Revit, and I intend to do a joint session with Revit and 3ds Max 2024. Let's see how it works on. If everything is proper, then you will be also having a Revit, the technical manager for Revit part over here with me. I'll be showing for 3ds Max 2024. Let's see how it works on. Otherwise, we'll be doing Revit feature first and then Max, and then we'll have a joint session. How it will be working, we'll figure it out internally and we'll definitely post you on that. So just stay updated by following us on LinkedIn. And that's it from me. This is Jignesh. Anything from your end, Shirish?
Yeah. So guys, thank you so much for being a part of this session. All the attendees were waited and paid attention to the session. All right. So we come to the final phase of today's webinar. And we have few announcements and we have few quizzes for all of you, as we mentioned at the beginning. I hope that I'm visible. Okay. All right. So the first thing that we want to share with you is that Capricorn became a global organization by merging with four giants across the globe, and we became WinZero. So if you see in our logo, you'll see that Capricorn is now a WinZero company. This happened a year back, and this was a very big amalgamation of four big giants: US CADLINE, US CAD, then CADLINE Infotech, A2K Technologies, and Capricorn Technologies. All four of us came together to form even a larger organization so that we are able to cater to your needs or technical. We can be a better technical support on a global level. Now we have even a bigger announcement to make to you that now WinZero has been taken over by Arcans, which is one of the giants in the global market when it comes to designing solutions. Okay, and they have been prevailing for a very, very long time, a legacy that they carry. So let me just share my screen and show you how we have become a global organization now. So I'm sure that I request all of you that we have shared a link in the chat box, and in the chat box you'll be able to see the link to our LinkedIn channel. So Arcans, so now we are a part of both WinZero and Capricorn are now a part of Arcans, and we have now increased our presence from four major continents to almost 32 countries, which is a very big jump for us. This shows our strength in terms of being able to serve you for your issues or your problems and your projects more efficiently. So we have become more resilient now. We have become more competent now. Our reach is not limited to India alone. We are undertaking and connecting with clients globally. So that's how Capricorn as a WinZero and now as a part of Arcans has grown in the last one and a half year. Now, coming back to the quiz and special gesture by Mr. Jignesh Mistry. So here is a question. I believe all of you have the question on the screen. You just need to click on the link in the chat box and go to this option. Whosoever answers first will be declared and given a special gift voucher from Jignesh. So you have another 1 minute to quickly answer this question. The question is, when performing direct material assignment, materials are created under which material scope name? Is it standard only, standardized, or user desired both, user desired, or none? So you have 1 minute starting now to answer the question. Whosoever answers first wins the prize. Clock is ticking and time starts now. Okay, 16 seconds ago, the first person to answer was Rushabh, and his answer is standard only. The second to answer was Mahesh, recently, just 2 seconds back, standard only. Jignesh, I need your, we'll wait for more, 20 to 30 seconds, 20 seconds more, to see if anyone else answers, if there is a differences in the opinion and in the answers that we get from the people. Come on, guys. Ten more seconds.
You have to answer the question in LinkedIn. Khushbu Verma just answered on the.
Yeah, so you'll have to answer it on the LinkedIn post. So we have just shared the link in the comments. So Rushabh was the first, Mahesh was the second. We are just waiting for the third person to answer. Come on, guys. Is it standard only, standardized, or user desired both? Is it user desired or is it none? Okay, we have a third comment. User desired. Okay. All right. And I guess the time is up, Jignesh.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. So, unfortunately, guys, none of you are right. The correct answer is standardized
and user desired both.
It's both. So Jignesh, I would want you to give the explanation to that. Why?
Yes. Actually, when you are actually applying any sort of a material, okay, you can get n number of list of materials and everything plus a user one. So it is both. You have both the options. See it very carefully while you are applying the material.
All right. We hate to say this, but for now, we don't have any winners for this particular quiz.
I know it was a bit of a difficult one, a tricky one.
It was a tricky one. So stay tuned. So it's not that this is the end of us giving out gift vouchers. We are very, very active on LinkedIn, on Instagram, and also on Facebook. So our team, we will share the link to all our channels in the chat box. Our team is doing that. So stay tuned to our channel. We are doing lots of activities. And as Jignesh said, the next webinar that we are going to hold in the month of June is going to be on 3ds Max 2024, its latest features. And we are also going to start a community, a WhatsApp community. The intention of this community, as we have discussed, is to give you a platform where you can quickly get response to any queries. So it's a channel where it's going to be a WhatsApp channel where everyone can post the screenshot queries, post a question and ask question to Jignesh. And we're going to add a few more technical people into it if possible. And this will be an absolute knowledge-based community. It will be a knowledge-sharing community, which will be called as ME community. We call it as media and entertainment community. We call it as ME community, ME community. We will soon be sharing a link to the WhatsApp group to all those who have participated here. Do join the WhatsApp group.
Also share it with your friends.
This WhatsApp group is going to be non-advertised. There will be no advertisements. There will be no discussions on anything about business.
Strictly technical.
No one is allowed to post any kind of promotional activities on that group. So all the instructions will be laid down on the group. And all of you are required to be a part of this group, only with the intention of exchanging knowledge. So this community, we wish to make this community very large with the help of WhatsApp, as it is the very fast and smartest way to stay connected other than social media. So stay tuned. You will receive the WhatsApp link on the mobile number which you have registered with for this particular webinar, and share that particular community with the right set of people. It's going to be, we will be screening people who will be joining, because we want only relevant people from the industry to be a part of that particular group. All right, so stay tuned. And once again, thank you so much, everyone, for being a part of this session.
I did, sorry to interrupt. I did answer some of the questions were there in the Q&A. If there is any other questions apart from that, please do type in. We can spend more 5 minutes more.
Yeah.
Shirish, yeah?
Yeah. So we'll just wait for another 1 or 2 minutes to see if anyone has any questions.
Anyone has any questions? Because one of the questions that Mr. Anonymous attendee, I don't know whose name is this, he just asked any update about lighting. So I just gave an update. Arnold came with a physical-based lighting right now. That is the update all right now. If you want any further detailed topic on that, I'll be happy to do a detailed session, maybe with an industry expert also, who will be actually working on lighting, and if he wants to share his work about lights part or something like that, even animation. I intend to do a detailed session maybe in future with an animator, because we did something in for lighting in event that we held on 15th February. So maybe the next session would be more on animation.
Right. So guys, stay tuned with us. We are here to help you out. We are here to help you advance, upskill. The media and entertainment industry is growing. It's dynamic. It's superbly tech savvy. It's cloud based. It's IoT. Everything is coming. And, you know, the technological growth is phenomenal. So staying updated is the best way to stay ahead. And stay with, match your pace with the industry standards. So that's what we are here for as Caprica Technologies.
Yeah. And in addition, I'll just add up to something that the traditional way of the softwares that were there from last 2 decades, which is Max and Maya, to be very fair, they are improving its as per the need and requirement of the community as a media and entertainment community that you have. So please be active on the forums, which is directly sponsored by the company. Area is one, okay? And if you have any queries or something like that, we are also the channel partner. We also put forth to Autodesk and technical departments. Their boss, our clients are facing this. Do you have any solution? Okay, because many times we do agree the fact that everything is not goody-goody. Everything is not goody-goody. When you are working on project, somewhere or the other, you are getting stuck because of some feature or something or the other. Okay. So I totally personally understand the pinpoints of the production guys and the people who are working on projects. Because I personally used to work on, and I'm still somewhere or the other, I do such kind of a consultancies also for production houses where they require certain features in their production pipeline. We did such kind of a sessions also for hair. We will be doing it topic specific on Maya, on Max, anything you require. The requirement should come from you guys. You be open more on such kind of forum. Capricorn has one forum on LinkedIn. Autodesk has another forum known as Area. Be active and be vigilant. Increase your skills by whatever version that you are working on. See, versions do come to support you guys, not to create more headaches. People have one sort of an intention. I have actually used this version for a long time. I'm much more comfortable. See, that's what happens. You are in your comfort zone. If you want to increase the optimum level of your work and your production pipeline, make sure you see what all features are also added. These days, the new versions that are coming are not additional headache, but they will be giving you further enhancement to your projects. As as USD, as LookBay, graph editors. These are some of the key features that you should take away from today's session and make sure you apply it into your current projects. That's what you can do. Okay.
Perfect. So, so guys, with this, we come to the end of the session. Once again, we would like to thank you all. Please share your feedbacks and your reviews on our channel. We would be more than happy to assist you and stay tuned to our channel.
I do get something. Hello, sir. Can you make procedural material in Maya or Max as like a substance? Yeah, of course we can. PBR materials are there. PBR materials are there, Mr. Naresh. Of course you can. Of course you can. Sir, does USD file support rigging and up? Yeah, that's the thing. And animation also, if I wanted to, if I want animation to be sent as USD, it will support. Absolutely. No problem.
Perfect.
Okay. Thank you.
All right. Thank you so much once again, guys. Thank you so much for spending so much time with us. And hope you had a great session. Thank you so much. Enjoy your lunch. Enjoy your weekend. Have a blast. I know it's Saturday. So have a great Saturday evening. Thank you so much. Signing off. This is Shirish Yadav and Jignesh Mistry from Capricorn Technologies. Bye-bye, guys.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.